ist ja die von Switzerland, also today we're gonna do my year-end full collection overview featuring my fixed plates, my folders and all my EEC kind of gear, and I'm also going to show you how I store my knives at the moment here, and I have it in this Pelican case 1520. I have this now probably for 2 years set up like this. I made some custom inserts in a company here from Switzerland for it, and I have it in some kind of a stacked order. So I have a bottom piece where I have all my miscellaneous things like pens, sheath and things like that. Also my tools for taking knives apart, my lube and things like that is all in there. And then I have three stacks of knives in tray configured inserts, and they are ranked from low to high price. So let's take a look while opening up here this Pelican case. So this is the bottom part of my Pelican case. You can see here this custom inlay with the blue color here to set it apart. And here I have my two Weiha Xiaomi collaboration bit sets that I use to disassemble and clean out my knives or do some tweaks to them. I have two because if you have a free spinning pivot, you're always better off if you have the same bit twice, and also two drivers. So I really like these Weiha bit sets here. They look gorgeous, they fit very nicely in this case here, and just a very nice high quality set. And you've got a bunch of different Weiha bits in here for different kind of knives you should use, and you have also high quality materials as you're used to from Weiha, and just in a very gorgeous overall package. So these are my two Weiha kits. Then here on the right we have some miscellaneous things. We have my business cards for the channel. We have one very small knife, as you can see right here. This is a knife I got once in a trade and I just like it too much to get rid of it. This is a Burker Plus Keycom with some aftermarket Lightning Strike carbon fiber scales. Super small knife, not really useful, but just a gorgeous little piece, and I just can't get myself to selling it. And I believe these scales are made by Coscati, which is a German company that builds some custom scales. So a very neat little thing. It's just as large as its pocket clip. So interesting thing, not really using or carrying this, just lives here in this case here. Then I have my backup or a holiday kind of wallet. This is my original gun deck from Das Offenemeer leather, or now called Open Sea leather. Very nice functional minimalist wallet made from one single piece of leather. Has some nice green stitching there, worked perfectly well. But now I went to the other style of wallet that he makes, which is called the Topsider. So this just lives in here and gets used for when I go on holidays. Then here we also have some different kind of sheath from some knives that I have here. This is probably from the Arnaud Bernard. This is from the, how is it called, the Livry. And at the bottom we have the one from the Nandi. Then we have some knife news little knife bags in there. I have some aftermarket clips and things, and then we have a microfiber cloth for cleaning some knives. So that's everything that is in there. Then here on this side we have some tools and some leftover fidget spinners here that were once a big deal. This is from Aesthetics, and this is another very interesting one in the form of a atomic hazard sign from a US company where I can't remember the name at the moment. And then we have some paracord. We have a nice pry bar that I actually have to review. This is the Glow Rhino pry bar that features a nice 3GM insert right there, made out of titanium, and just a nice little pry bar. Works very well, nicely made, and lives in here for the moment, but I will put it on my keychain. You also have a little driver here at the back, and then I will carry and use it, and then you will see a little update on this pry bar once I do an EDC update kind of video. And just a little interesting thing here, the Glow Rhino pry bar. I have some kind of a no-name lighter in here Then I have the tool for the 0609. So for disassembling that one, this comes in handy. And then I have this one here, which is the lanyard cube by Sharp Dressed Knives, which is a very neat tool to have when you're disassembling some paramilitary 3s or paramilitary 2s or other knives from Spyderco that has these pinned lanyard inserts, because you can really push it out just like this without having to fiddle with it without any problem breaking the scales. So this is a great little tool from Sharp Dressed Knives. Go check that out, the lanyard cube, very interesting piece there. Then you can also take a look at the part right here, which I have my smaller EDC fixed blades, or just my smaller fixed blade that I have in the collection, not really something that I carry a lot of the time. This is the Mini Samurai by Cheburkov Knives. Gorgeous hammered titanium bolster, stainless steel Damascus from Zladinox. Just a gorgeous kind of leather opener, or just gorgeous piece to display for the collection. So very nice knife, comes in a good leather sheath here. And then we have another custom fixed blade. This is by Derek Pinkerton. It's his Subtle Warning model. Some gorgeous Matrix Damascus by Vegas Forge, carbon fiber handles, nice and small, super thinly ground. Absolutely gorgeous piece. There is a particular video on this knife itself, so go check that out. It will be linked here in the top right corner. Then we have knife pivot lube, the regular one and the heavier weight, which comes in very handy as well. Great material, really improves the action super fast on all of your knives. Then I have my first knife that I ever got. This is the Kershaw Chill, which I heavily overpaid for here in Switzerland, but it was a great knife and it got me completely into the hobby. Still has a pretty reasonable action. Now it has a polished blade, came with a blasted one, and not really a knife that I'm going to use or carry anymore, but it just lives in here as a little bit of a reminder where everything started with the knives and the channel. So this is the first knife I ever got, it that will certainly stay in here for a good long time. Maybe we can put it here for the moment. Then here we have another pry bar. This is the Croco tool by Mazarin Knives. This is made out of steel. We have a nice paracord wrap, which makes it much more comfortable to actually use there. We have some additional features, bottle opener, this little crank tool. So very interesting thing here. I'm not carrying a lot of these pry bars regularly because I don't have that much use for a pry bar. You know, I'm a doctor. I work in an office and in the hospital most of the times. And that's why I just have these two and carry them from time to time. Then I have a bunch of pens here. First off, I have three different versions of the Fisher Space pens here. The regular kind of one with the pocket clip. Then this gorgeous brass one that is actually sealed in a clear coat, so it's not going to patina. And then we have the raw brass, which actually has patinaed quite a bit right now. Gorgeous pieces, very inexpensive and just good overall pens, even though the writing with them can be a little bit chalky, especially at the beginning. You can get some little droplets, but after that, they were great and they are just great EDC-sized pens. So these are the Fisher Space pen. Then I have an Investigator pen by Rick Hinderer. This is a olive green aluminum version. It also has, I believe, a Fisher Space pen refill. Great little clip, nice EDC pen with the O-ring. It doesn't come loose, but you can kind of ruin your pants with that nice and thin pocket clip, which carries very deep, but you can really open up your seams on the pocket when you're carrying that. You also have the bullet style impact device here on the other side. Interesting little pen, very, very lightweight. Then we have my favorite pen at the moment for EDC is this one here, the Peter Döring bolt action pen built by Lion Steel. Nice deep carry clip here. Once I lost the screw at the top and couldn't carry it for a while, but now it's reinstated. Great customer service by Peter Döring and Lion Steel there. Super cool bolt action pen. Great size. You can even get some extenders if you want to have a longer one, but your actual refill is quite a short one, so you have to replace that quite a lot if you're carrying this and using this a lot. Then we have the Boecker Plus 50 cal pen in brass. My first bolt action pen here works still very well. Reasonable clip, not my absolute favorite, and this is kind of a heavy and thick pen. If you like that, this is certainly one of the more affordable bolt action pens that you can get your hands on. And then probably my most beautiful pen is this one here. This is the Lion Steel Niala pen in super dense twist damasteel and the bronze anodized titanium. Very, very gorgeous. You have the twisty tail cap right there, and an absolutely gorgeous pen that I keep on my desk normally in the little wooden stand that it actually came with. So absolutely gorgeous piece here, the Niala pen by Lion Steel. So this wraps up this bottom part of my EDC collection or knife collection, and it's also the bottom part of this Pelican case. And now let's move on to my fixed blades, and then we get to the different layers of the EDC case. So now we move on to the fixed blades in my collection. Also, you will find some timestamps in the description below, so you can switch around between the folders, the fixed blades, and the EDC stuff that you saw in the beginning. So let's start off with the fixed blades. I don't have a lot of fixed blades in terms of a little bit larger fixed blades, but I have a couple and I really love the ones that I still have. So this is a gorgeous knife by Kaiser Knives. This is the Little River Bowie, also designed by Dirk Pinkerton. You have a smooth micarta, a smooth G10 handles. We have a 1095 blade with a powder coat on it, an absolutely super gorgeous blade shape, nice and sharp out of the box. The handle is an ergonomic dream in all the grips you put on it. It's super, super comfortable. It's not overly thick, but still gives you something to hold on. You have some good functional jimping here on the spine of the blade, as well as in the back right here. Lanyard loop, three very large torque screws for attaching the handles. You have a good guard in the front, so this is a great overall piece from Kaiser Knives, and these are just at $100, an absolute recommendation to buy it. Great steel, very, very amazing design. You have a good tip. This can work as an amazing fighting knife, or even a camp knife. Works great at preparing wood for firewood and things like that. An absolutely great camp style knife. You get a good Kydex sheath here. You even have the belt clip attached there. You get a drain hole here on this side, and it fits in here very, very nicely. There is no real rattle, everything fits perfectly. So I think this is probably one of the best values out there, the Kaiser Knives Little River Bow, designed by Dirk Pinkerton at $100 for 1095 in G10. We have an amazing design, great ergonomics, and a very, very functional and good looking blade shape. So this is the first one. Then we have the fixed blade that is the longest time now in my collection. This is the Southern Grind Jackal. This is more of my hard use beater, super heavy chopping kind of blade. It's not super large, but it's very, very thick, 52-100 steel there. Very, very heavy piece, super ergonomic as well, with some gorgeous green G10 handles. There are a bunch of versions you can configure with the coating and everything. I went with the FDE here on this particular knife. Oh, it's not 52-100, sorry, it's their special 8670M steel, which is made from a recycled sawmill blade. So very interesting stuff there. You have the older Southern Grind logo, and just a super, super well-made knife. You've seen it has been used and abused, and still is an absolutely great piece. Also love the Jackal logo here, and the quality is just there, and Southern Grind is a very, very charitable company. All their proceeds go to Camp Southern Grind, which is a charitable organization run by Zac Brown of the Zac Brown Band, which is also the owner of this knife. So if you want to get a heavy duty US made, very very functional and very high quality fixed blade, check out the Southern Grind Jackal. You also get a great green kydex sheath, which will be matching to all the other colors that you have chosen. And we have a drainage hole, we have the clip as well, and also a great fit on that sheath. Very very solid there, and just a great knife, and one of my favorites in the collection, the Southern Grind Jackal. Then the second longest in my collection is this one here. This is my only custom fixed blade, if you don't count the smaller fixed blades you have seen in the overview before, is this one here. This is the TK Knives Telhar, which is a full custom knife from TK Knives out of the Czech Republic, made to my specifications. We have a gorgeous green micarta handle, we have some red liners, we have a stonewashed blade here of their proprietary carbon steel that they use, super thinly ground. This is probably the closest I have to a true bushcraft knife. We have broken edges here at the top, just this part right here. Maybe you can appreciate here, we have this part right here which has no chamfer, and this is made so you can actually strike a ferro rod. This was also made at special request on my part, and we just have such a useful drop point blade shape, super super thin and sharp, and the ergos here are absolutely amazing, very nice and hand filling handle there. We have a lanyard hole, we have some easy to take apart screws there, and it's just an absolutely gorgeous knife here, the Telhar by TK Knives. The sheath is well done. It's not super impressive. You see that they are custom knife makers that do everything by hand. You can see how they finished off this attachment here. The kydex is actually done very well and a very good fit, but this nylon kind of part is a little bit showing the handmade stuff that they do, but it still works very well for a great camp or a bushcrafting knife. And you can see it's a very very tight fit, nothing that you're going to lose here, and to draw it, it's just like this. So very very nice piece here, the TK Knives Telhar, my only custom larger fixed blade. There's also a video on all of these knives on my channel, maybe except for the Kaiser. And then my most recent acquisition in terms of fixed blades is this one here. You probably know from the sheath that it's going to be a Bark River knife. This is the Gunny Sidekick. The blade is designed by Rob from the Apostle P channel, and this is an absolutely gorgeous piece. Love the V2 Gunny Sidekick blade without the enormous notch that the first one had. And we have some orange liners, gorgeous polished micarta scales. We have 3V steel, and this is just an absolutely gorgeous knife. I think this is probably my most gorgeous fixed blade that I have. We have some brass pins, absolutely gorgeously sculpted handle that make it very very comfortable. Of course it's not going to have the traction you have on a lesser finished micarta like you have it here, so for use I probably would prefer my Telhar here, but in terms of looks, this is certainly super super well done. Anti 3V steel is certainly a great performer. Also sharpening wise, this is so well done, and I absolutely love the Bowie blade shape that Apostle P has worked on here with, in collaboration with Bark River Knives. And I certainly now can understand the image that Bark River Knives has. These are so well made knives, and really really well done, and an absolutely gorgeous piece here from Bark River Knives. So these are my fixed blades that I have in the collection: the Bark River Gunny Sidekick, the TK Knives Custom Telhar, the Southern Grind Jackal, full size Jackal, and then we have the most affordable and highly recommended Kaiser Knives Little River Bowie. So let's move on at my first inlay for the 1520 Pelican case you have seen before. And this is the lowest end inlay that I have there, which lives also just over the EDC gear bottom part that you have seen before. First off, let's take a look at two knives that have not found space in here at the moment. First off, I have this one here. This is a knife that has been reviewed recently. This is the Viper Knives Balone, absolutely gorgeous Voxnase design, carbon fiber handles, titanium liner lock, and M390 blade. Absolutely gorgeous slender piece with a great deep carry clip, and I have to find a place for it in my overall storage, and maybe another knife has to go so it can find its place. And the other knife that I have is the Grayman Knives Dua. This is not in this case because it's actually up for sale. A great knife here, mid-tech kind of knife, very well executed, 20 CV blade, super thick, stout knife, reminds me a little bit of a Medford or a Strider. Very smooth action overall, great aftermarket a mirror polished edge, and also the finishing work has some aftermarket work done to it. Frame lock has a Sabenta style bushing pivot, and I'm asking $400 shipped internationally for the Grayman Dua. So if you're interested, let me know in the comments below, and maybe we can work something out in terms of buying this knife from me, because this is actually at the moment for sale. Condition is great, action is great, just an amazing piece, but I have to make room for some new stuff that is coming in. Now let's take a look at this little inlay right here. So you see the same kind of theme, just with as much space as I could fit into the overall form factor of that 1520 Pelican case. Let's start out down here. So this is one of my favorite knives from, I believe, 2018, where I crowned this my knife of the year. This is a Fox Knives Tour, carbon fiber handles, L-Max blade, made by Fox in collaboration with Jesper Voxnase, one of my favorite designers. And you can see very nice knife, super ergonomic, good clip, liner lock, works great, and just is an absolute benchmark piece for a great EDC overall design, and just shows off the Jesper Voxnase lines very well. Then moving forward, we have one of my few Spyderco knives. This is the Spyderco Reinhold Rhino, features their laminated carbon fiber and ZTS XHP blade steel, as well as the compression lock. This is a nice small EDC, which is super ergonomic, even though it looks a little bit odd in the hand because you have this protruding piece right here, but in the hand it is super ergonomic, has a nice thin grind here on the blade, and just looks very interesting. Had the standard kind of Spyderco clip on it. I changed it for a bug-eyed clip, and now it's one of my favorite lightweight summer kind of carry or even backup carry knives. This is certainly a great design by Mr. Reinhold and Spyderco, the little Rhino here. Then we have a discontinued knife from Benchmade. This is the Benchmade Sequel 707, which was discontinued. This is the standard version with the kind of G10 inlay there, aluminum handles, and the 154cm blade steel, a McHenry & Williams design. And I just like the design of this knife. I would love to have one of the latest versions with the blue anodized and grooved aluminum scales that, for example, Ben Banters has, but I really like to have this one in the collection. It has a little bit of a stiffer action than some of my other Axis Lock knives had, but it still is an absolutely gorgeous piece. I love how it has a very broad blade that you don't think would fit into the handle. Also ergonomically, it's a very good knife. So this is more of a nostalgic knife, doesn't get carried very much, but I just love to have a Sequel in the collection. Also has the standard upgraded deep carry clip. I believe it came with a split arrow clip, so I swapped out this Benchmade clip on this knife just to make it look and carry even a little bit better once at the time that I also carried this. Now it's just more of a keepsake here in the collection. Other Benchmade knives that you certainly have seen if you follow my channel, because this is one of my standard kind of size comparison, this Bug Out with aftermarket scales from Allen Putman. Nice grooved aftermarket scales. It's the coated version in S30B of the full-size Bug Out. Amazingly lightweight, great pocket clip, nice standoffs, no issues with instability or anything with these micarta scales, great action on the access lock, and just a great EDC piece, especially in this color, in this combination with the micarta and decoded blade. I think it looks very sick, and this will certainly stay very long in the collection, just for size comparison and also for using as a great lightweight EDC. I think the Bug Out is one of the best knives Benchmade has ever brought out. Then other kind of standard size comparison is this one here. This is the Spyderco Para 3, which was in the original form actually given to me as a gift from a viewer, which I'm very, very thankful for. This is the standard version with S30B steel. Then I bought these aftermarket scales from Sharp Dressed Knives, where you also saw the pocket cube from. And I used the pocket cube to push out this lanyard and make it very easy to install these aftermarket scales. And then I also have a Casey Lynch aftermarket deep carry clip. It's the standard one, not the Para 3 particular one where they have the cutout for the lanyard, but I'm never going to use a lanyard, so that's not an issue for me. Of course, compression lock and everything you love on a Para 3 actually gets carried also quite a bit, just because it's such a functional EDC piece. Then we have this one here, one of the longest members of the collection at the moment. This is the Bucher Knives Bullpup, a knife that everybody should buy. I think these have now been discontinued. They are at around $100 and are such nice knives. I think it's the best thing that Bucher Knives has ever brought out. We have on the steel, I have to check, I believe it's VG10 on the steel. You have a hollow grind with a nice and reflective stonewash finish. We have titanium bolsters. We have a stainless steel liner lock, which is pretty beefy. We have an aluminum backspacer, carbon fiber scales with these nice bolsters there. We have phosphor bronze washers. We have these angled thumb studs that you're maybe used to from the Blur line, and everything works very well, nice and smooth. A little bit of hefty knife. We have a four-way reversible, not a two-way reversible pocket clip. We have tip down and tip up. I left it like that, so the clip lands on the titanium and is easier to get in and out of the pocket. And of course, it's one of my favorite designs by Charles Marlow, the Bulldog or Bullpup design. And until I get a custom, which I hope that will ever happen, this will stay in the collection to remind me of this great design here. Gorgeous Bowie kind of blade, and certainly the best thing that Bucher has ever made. Very nice piece overall, good materials, well executed, and an amazing custom design by Charles Marlow. So if you can find one of these Bucher Bullpups, go and get them. This is a must-have for any kind of knife collector, in my opinion. The Bucher Plus Bullpup is the way to go. Then let's move to here. This is my favorite Kaiser knife ever in terms of folding knife. My favorite fixed blade you saw before is this one here, the Little River Bowie, designed by Derek Pinkerton. And here we have the Kaiser Knives Guru, designed by Matt Degnan, which is an absolutely very, very well done knife. We have bearings here, nice blasted titanium, which is very rare for Kaiser that they actually do this nice darker and a little bit more tractionable blasted finish. Then this is the whole version without the flipper tab, which is the one that I would recommend. Also the full tie version without the flipper tab looks quite nice, but I think this knife was designed to be used without a flipper tab. It's a little bit thick on the stock, gets a pretty nice edge there, nice sheep's foot blade, super ergonomic. You can even do the foregrip right there. We have a lanyard hole, we have a nice unobtrusive 3D milled titanium clip, and the action on these Gurus is just so well dialed in. Just an amazing knife, and for the prices that they go for, I believe they are at around 130, 150, something like that. With S30V steel satin finish blade, nice titanium frame lock, and great ball bearing action. I think this is certainly one to get if you want to get into some good titanium frame locks. You even get the over travel stop and the stainless steel lock bar insert, so that is certainly a great piece. An older one, but certainly still one that is in production as far as I know, and one you should get maybe together with the bullpup. Then here at the top we have a newer knife from this year. This is a super lightweight, super minimalist slip joint from Fox Knives out of Maniago, Italy. I think this is an in-house design, running M390 and micarta scales. There are also wood scaled versions of this knife available. Nice little recurve, Bowie style blade shape, very very functional, super easy to carry. You even have a lanyard hole there, and this is would also make a great gift for someone that is not really into knives but would need one. Also very easy to deploy, a little bit of a softer spring but still quite secure. We have some jimping, and just a great gift knife, great light task EDC blade, great office knife, great knife for a woman because it also carries very small and slender, so very easy to carry even in smaller pockets. So this is certainly a very very good option, and it's at around or just under $100 for M390 and micarta, made in Italy, and it's just an overall very well made knife. Of course it's a pin construction, so keep that in mind, but I really like the livery here. There's also another blade shape available with a sheep's foot blade shape, so this is certainly something you should take a look at. The only reason this didn't make my top 10 knives of 2020 list is because I got an even nicer Italian made slip joint that took the spot for me, but this is certainly one of the best knives of 2020 for me, the Fox Knives livery. Then moving on, also a knife that is longer in the collection, this is the CRKT Pilar with some aftermarket micarta scales there. It's the original version with ACR certain MOV and the stainless steel lock bar. I kept this one tipped down as well because it carries a little bit deeper, and still running the plastic washers, the nylon washers that they have in there. But ergonomically, this is just so nice, and it embodies the overall design language from Jesper Voxnes so well that this will also be staying in the collection, also because selling it wouldn't add a lot to the knife budget, so I still keep it around as a great EDC piece, and it certainly would be also one of the best CRKT knives available just because of the design and how affordable it is. And there have been a bunch of different versions of this knife with better steels, with carbon fiber scales, I believe even one with a titanium frame lock. So go and choose the one you like the best, and you will not be disappointed with this great EDC piece. And it's also a knife that is not aggressive in any way, so it's easy to pull it out in an urban environment and use it and do what you need to do and put it away again. Very very neat piece. If there is any time a nice high-end version of a great steel micarta handle scales, titanium frame lock, or even a liner lock from Jesper Voxnes or Giant Mouse or any other company, I probably will pick that up. But I just love this design so much that if there is not a perfect version to switch it out with, this will stay in the collection like it is. Then another CRKT that you saw in the top 10 knives video is the Inara. Very nice, lightweight EDC gentleman's or office style carry, designed by Richard Rogers, very affordable, under $50, ATR certain MOV, G10 stainless steel and IKBS bearing system. A really surprisingly good knife, great action, super nice detent there, and very useful in its blade size. Other CRKT. You realize I'm quite big of a fan of CRKT. I think they have some great designs at some good budget points. I just wish they would have some better steel options, even though that meant to have a little bit a higher price point. But this is also an older piece in my collection. This is the CRKT Ripple. This, I believe this is the Ripple 2, the redesigned version with a little bit of a different blade shape. Very Canonian-like. It's the only Canonian design I have left in the collection. You also see all the billboarding there. We have a Kudo 440 steel, which is an upgrade from ATR or anything like that. And I love these bronze treated stainless steel frame lock handles. The clip is a little bit of a miss, but certainly a great design piece. Also nothing that I carry very often, but it is certainly an absolutely gorgeous piece. Has IKVS bearings and a rounded spine. So really a nice, nice piece from CRKT. Probably one of their nicest older designs that they have ever done. And it's also super, super thin. But still remains to be great ergonomically. So this is the Ripple, an older knife, and I believe these are at the moment like $50 if you still can get them. There is also a black version available of the Ripple. And then we have here a knife from Real Steel. This is the Real Steel H6S1, probably one of my most recommended budget knives. We have 14C28N steel, G10 stainless steel frame lock. You even have a secondary lock feature like you get, for example, on some line steel knives. Deep carry clip, super ergonomic, full flat grind, nice and thinly ground. Unfortunately, you have a slight recurve. Would love to see that gone, but other than that, this is probably the best. Buy a knife, buy one knife, have one knife for everything. Great EDC tool, good stainless steel with some great edge retention at a budget, and just has everything that you could need. I really love to use this when I'm moving, and I moved quite a bit this year, I believe 4 times, and it's just a great knife to have around, a knife that you don't feel bad using and abusing. And it still held up quite well. So Real Steel H6 is one, pretty much a benchmark budget EDC folder. Go check that one out if you're interested. All of these knives have their individual reviews, and because I can't link them all, you can find them on my channel. Just put in the name of the knife and you will find the individual review of it. Here we have another CRKT. This is the CRKT Overland. Great JT Schwartz design. Reminds me a little bit of the Perpetua, just much more affordable and without the access lock. And this is just a great EDC piece, very affordable, new for 2020, also part of my top 10 list of 2020. Still, ATR Stepnemov, which is certainly always a thing that I would like to see improved, but ergonomically and design-wise, also with the color combination with the orange and green and black wash, I really like that here on this particular version. Normally, I'm not a big fan of this black wash kind of finish, but here I think it fits. And just the overall ergonomics and design, as well as the blade and the nice grind here, certainly add to this piece. And I think for a budget knife, this certainly packs a lot of character and is a very nice piece. So this concludes the lowest tier of my inlay pieces for the EDC collection. Let's move one up. So now we are at the mid-range of the collection inlay. Here we have some higher-end knives, but not any customs, and let's start from the bottom right. Here we have the Bergblade Satin Pop with some aftermarket zirconium accents added to it in the clip and the pivot color. Very nice lower quantity produced knife here by Wee and Bergblade, and there is a new version coming with inlays as well. Gorgeous piece, hollow grind, 20 CV steel on bearings. A little bit of a chunky monkey, a little bit heavier than you would expect, but certainly one of my favorite smaller EDC pieces here, and just very well made. And there is also a fully stonewashed version available of this particular knife, and I believe in the beginning of next year we'll see the inlaid version, and I would certainly recommend to you to check them out and maybe get one. Pricing, we're talking here around $300 without the zirconium accents on this Wee knife made at Bergblade Pop. Then next up we have the HEA Designs Hunter. Carbon fiber version, 154cm on the blade, a great front flipper that is a little bit more affordable than your Chamois and things like that, and certainly the best knife design that HEA Knives has ever made, in my opinion. The most usable one, the most fun one in terms of different deployment methods. Now we have a titanium frame lock, 3D milled titanium pocket clip, multiple different opening methods. A very, very functional tip there, and just a super nicely symmetrical blade shape and the overall knife shape there. And it's still very ergonomic, easy to carry, and an actual good and usable folder. So this is the ATA Designs Hunter. Then here in this compartment we have two. This is actually a custom knife, contrary to my first statement. This is a affordable custom slip joint folder with a rust-proof steel. I believe this is Nitro V for the blade steel. We have a carbon fiber bolster and micarta handle scales. This knife is a little bit rough around the edges. There are some fit and finish issues, but it is a great knife. This also went once through the washers when I forgot it. It was my backup blade in the pants that I put into the washer. But it's very, very a nice overall design. It's nice and small, very easy to carry, and just a fun little custom knife. And it's also quite affordable. It's made by Sheepers Blade Works. At the moment, he's more into building custom kitchen knives, but he is getting back into folders. He also had a flipper once in the next year. As far as I am concerned, I just talked to him about that, and that I would look forward to getting some more knives from him, because I really like his design language, and I think this little custom slip joint is just a very nice thing. And he is located in Australia, so you're paying in Australian dollars, and for that matter, his prices are actually quite reasonable, especially with the international shipping. So he has done a great job there. Then the second knife here is also a little bit an older one. This is the first generation Micro Typhoon by Brian Addo and Riyadh Knives. Absolutely gorgeous piece, very, very good looking, great size, slightly challenged pocket clip if you have thicker pants. But other than that, we have a nice stainless steel insert. We have his milled detent knob construction, which gives you a very, very clean detent break. Very, very smooth overall. We have the carbon fiber inlaid version. There were also a black with a white G10 inlay. And now there have been the Evo Micro Typhoon, which have an overall different design, different kind of blade shapes, fullers, and a bunch of different things added to them. But I'm pretty much happy with my original Micro Typhoon. Super well done, great size, very functional, gorgeous Brian Addo design. Here you can see his logo, and just very well executed by Riyadh Knives, and certainly a designer or a knife collaborator where you should look at to get something built by Riyadh from, or from him directly if you can afford a custom, because he has very, very good action, very, very nice designs, and just seems to be a master of his craft. So this is the Micro Typhoon by Riyadh and Brian Addo from Sharp by Designs. Then we have the RJ Martin designed ZT0609 with an aftermarket bronze anodized clip there. Great knife, probably the best thing that ZT has done in terms of their regular production line, in my opinion. Really is the higher end, more refined version of the RJ Martin designed Chili. So just in the beginning of the video, so this is a little bit of a sentimental one for me. You have the see-through pivot. You also saw that I have the tool to take it apart now. You have an absolutely gorgeous drop point blade shape. Very, very nice. One of the biggest reasons I still have this knife, the blade shape is just so gorgeous. You have 20 CV steel, nicely ground, very, very ergonomic for my small to medium hand size. We have some good jimping, not too aggressive, but you get a little bit of an indexing spot there. We have some nice standoffs in the back, which look a little bit like hinder standoffs actually, and some gorgeous overall milling. And I really like that they went with the bronze here. You just have to switch out the clip to this deep carry clip, and then it makes a great EDC piece for carrying and using. So this is the ZT0609 with an aftermarket clip. Great ZT knife, probably the best production piece that they have done so far. Then my last Spydeco folder is this one here. This is the Spidey Chef, certainly a knife that most of you will know. LC200N rust-proof steel. Great deep carry wire clip, the most affordable in my opinion, also the best Martin Sleesh collaboration with Spyderco. I handled or had all of the other ones except the Techno 1. So I had the Techno 2, I had the Sleesh Bowie, and I had this Wayback in hands and used them. I only owned this one and the Techno 2. All of them are have some good points and some bad points, but I think overall, if you want to get a knife from Spyderco and Martin Sleesh, I think the Spidey Chef has the most to offer for you. Good finish on the blade and the handle. It's not the fully high-end polished stonewash you get on the Sleesh Bowie or Swayback, but I actually like this finish on Spyderco knives. You have a great steel of LC200N, you have good ergonomics, you have a great clip. It's not contoured, but I just prefer it. So I think this is the best Sleesh collaboration, and that's also why it's the only one that I have in my collection. Then this is a little special one. This is the MDD-K by Wingman EDC, I believe also produced by Riyadh. This is a collaboration between Lee Williams, who invented the kickstop mechanism you saw right there in action, and Wingman EDC, which is, I believe, a company that is in part owned by the owner of Recon One, and then also Tom Mayo, which provided his design of the Dr. Death Flipper. So a three-way collaboration, or four-way collaboration, because the knife is built by Riyadh, and it's a really impressive knife. The only thing I wish to change about this one is adding the hand drop satin blade, which came out later as an option when I already got this. But this is a very, very nice knife. I love the kickstop mechanism. I think it's better than the SLT spring-loaded tab from Gustavo Cecchini from GTC Knives that you could experience on the ZT collaboration that they have. I believe the 0055, if I'm not mistaken. And I really love the size and the overall design here of the Dr. Death. Great 3.25 inch blade. I believe it's M390 on the steel. It's not mentioned anywhere, but that's what I recall. And because you have that hidden flipper tab, it actually is a great four-finger full-sized handle there. Very ergonomic, 3D mill titanium. You get different kind of blade finishes and hole patterns, as well as handle finishes. And just an overall great knife. Also very good 3D mill pocket clip, actually, with blind screwed, with a hidden hardware construction there. And running on bearings, of course. So this is certainly a very interesting piece, also because it has that great kickstop mechanism. Now Wingman EDC has developed and released a bunch of different other knives. All of them are interesting, but I think this is still the favorite one that they have released for me personally. As I said, I just wish I waited for the hand drop satin version of this knife, but other than that, very happy with the Wingman EDC MDD-K. Then we have here, of course, big contender for best knife of 2020, the Protech Knives Malibu. Perfect action on a ball bearing pivot coupled with a button lock mechanism. Very ergonomic, super thinly ground, 20 CV blade steel, nice and functional tip there, all the marking hidden away on the spine of the blade. Nice integrated backspacer, perfect pocket clip, and pricing wise, I believe at around 180 or something like that. So affordable for all the high end things you're getting here. Of course, it's made in the USA by Protech. Very, very nice knife. Certainly one you should check out and get one if you have the money and they are available. The Protech Malibu, absolute fun fidgeting knife and just so well made. Very happy I could score one of these. Then here we have a couple of slip joint folders. This is the Viper Knives Key, designed by Jesper Voxnes. We have M390, titanium bolsters, and a micarta in or overlay. Super ergonomic, great size, 3.25 inch blade on this slip joint. Very, very strong backspring, good walk and talk. And then we have here, if you take a look at the backspring, this absolutely gorgeous handmade file work, as Viper Knives tells us. Rounded, polished backspring, perfect engagement here that you almost can't see it with the tang of the blade there. and great walk and talk. So this is my absolute favorite new slip joint for 2020. Super, super gorgeous, great design, and very functional overall size and execution, while still being an absolutely gorgeous piece of pocket jewelry with that file work there. And the other very high-end slip joint I have for you is this one here. This is the Arno Bernard Ring Hulls, made in South Africa, with snakeskin carbon fiber inlays. We have S35 VN steel, if I'm not mistaken. We have a clip that is removable. We also have a leather case to carry it in. Absolutely gorgeous design that is slightly inspired by the Chris Reeve Nundi, but it's larger than an M Nundi. It also feels much more robust than an M Nundi. It's like a crossover between an M Nundi and a Sebenza, a small Sebenza. Very, very nicely done. Great walk and talk, perfect overall fit and finish. There are a bunch of different gorgeous materials you can have for your inlay work, and it's very easy to deploy. Certainly a very high-end and good-looking slip joint, and certainly a knife that you should check out if you never heard of the Arno Bernard Ring Hulls. And I believe they're also working on a frame lock flipper knife at the moment, and I would love to check out one of those when they are available. Then here we have a Quiet Carry Drift, absolutely gorgeous piece, Vanex steel, super great edge retention and corrosion resistance, nice and high, very thinly ground blade. We have the knurled version, which is my absolute favorite because it's very, very grippy but not abrasive to the touch. Great overall size, super good deep carry pocket clip, stainless steel LC200 and lock bar insert, and it's a completely rust proof knife and an absolutely fun and functional EDC piece. Also nice and slender, so it's not going to bulk up your pockets. And it's also very easy to slide past and get something else out of that pocket, like your wallet or something like that. No flipper tab. Everything is nicely rounded and contoured. So this is an absolute home run piece from Quiet Carry, the Quiet Carry Drift, now in the collection for nearly a year. Then here we have another super home run knife from Quiet Carry. This is their first folding knife model, I believe. It's the Quiet Carry IQ. Great office EDC carry, deep carry milled clip, very slender overall design, super impressive action here on this small flipper tab, the very lightweight blade, and such a nice and free-falling action when you disengage that frame lock. Still rock solid lockup. We have LMAX steel on this version, satin finished blade, very nicely finished titanium body, super lightweight, but still you're getting a very nice and long cutting edge that you can actually use for some work. So this is a very nice and very underrated knife, the Quiet Carry IQ, because I think on pictures it doesn't strike you as exceptional as it actually is when you're getting it in your hand. The Quiet Carry IQ, my second favorite knife from Quiet Carry overall. And you know, I had a couple of their knives. I also had the Waypoint, which you see it's no longer in the overall collection update because I just like these two more. Then here we have the Riyadh Knives Bushido, which is a newer knife from Riyadh Knives, with some gorgeous polished burlap micarta handles, 3D milled clip, M390 on the blade steel, in-house design as they claim. We have a ball bearing front flipper with a titanium liner lock, a little bit of a chunky knife for its size, but absolutely gorgeous hand drop satin finish, nice ethnically inspired drop point blade shape with a swedge, and the whole knife has a slight curvature to it, which makes it absolutely gorgeous and overall fitting the overall quake and style theme. So very, very nicely done here on the Riyadh Knives Bushido. This is also a smaller knife, under 3 inches, so easier to carry in an office kind of environment or in an urban setting. So this is actually in the pocket quite a bit. Then we have the Hinderer Knives 3-inch XMA Team non-flipper tri-way pivot, which is a newer knife for me for this year. We have 20 CV on the blade steel, as you can see right here. It's fully made in the USA. Other than that, we have a pretty standard hinder, just have one aftermarket scales from RC Bladework with this black micarta scale. Works great, runs on the bearing pivot that is included in the tri-bay pivot system. A thing that I want to do is to add a deep carry pocket clip on this knife. If you have one or know where I can get a good one that will fit the 3-inch hinder, please let me know. And that's probably the only customization I will make on this knife. Other than that, it's pretty much perfect. Really love the performance, the ergonomics, and everything of this knife. Just the perfect hinder for my particular needs. The 3-inch non-flipper dry-bay pivot, I believe Gen 5 hinder here, XM18. Then here we have the Alliance Design EZE collaboration with Ray Laconico, as you can see here on the spine of the blade. This is actually a bolster lock. I believe it's my only bolster lock in the collection at the moment. So we have an absolutely gorgeous, aggressive, very nicely ground tanto blade shape, machine set in finish, horizontal and vertical. We have a hollow grind on the main bevel, transitioning into the flat grind at the tanto tip. Very robust tip there. Then we have the gorgeous titanium bolsters, micarta inlays, very nice 3D mil titanium clip. We have a lanyard hole, and the steel is S35VN. There were also different versions available, even ones with Damascus steel blades. And this is the one I settled for, and I'm very happy. These are actually no longer available. Maybe there will be a second run, but this has been gone for quite a while. Absolutely gorgeous piece, one of the best things that Alliance Design has produced, in my opinion. There is sometimes a little bit of lock stick, but very seldomly. And still an absolutely gorgeous piece, and probably my favorite overall design from Ray Laconico. So if you can get one of these aftermarket, I would highly recommend it. It's a great knife, it's an amazing design, and very well executed by Alliance Designs, and I believe Riot as well, even though they have not disclosed their manufacturer as far as I know. But it feels very, very Riot like for me here, the EZE by Alliance Designs. And the last piece for this layer here is this one here. This is a Leongma, also Riot built knife, the Leongma Hawk. Micarta inlays, great ceramic ball, deep carry pocket clip. Very, very overall gorgeous design. One of my favorite designs by Leongma. The only real Leongma I have in the collection, just because it has a great hollow ground blade, nice Wharncliffe blade shape. The only thing I don't like about these Leongma designs is that they just waste so much space on that cutting edge here with this botched up ricasso and heel area right here. They really should figure out a way to do that better. Here you can see the cutting edge just stops there where it's still in the primary grind. So that is certainly something I would like to have to see changed. Other than that, very strong detent. Nice and smooth overall action, great pocket clip, and also a great size at once again 3.25 inches of blade length. Now let's move on to the last layer here. And here we are at the top layer, my highest end knives, my custom knives that I have in the collection so far. And let's start this time at the top here. We have a Shirogorov F95NL I have in the collection now for over 1.5 years. This is one of my largest knives in the collection, and I keep it mostly for that it's just an absolutely gorgeous piece, but the action on this knife is absolutely sublime. As you can see right here, it was also my first Shirogorov I ever gotten, and it's just absolutely gorgeous. Love that they have brought out the version with micarta, which is the thing that put me at the end over the edge. And also the NL model here, it's one of the most affordable Shirogorov knives that are available. I believe these are just under $600 for LMAX steel, and everything else is standard kind of Shirogorov regular production features here. But the action on this is so amazing, just everything you would expect from a Shirogorov here, and that's why this will certainly stay in the collection. Also, I use this as a regular size comparison option. Then here we have the Shurigoro of Neon, which is the smaller brother to the NL. This is actually more expensive because this is the higher end version. It's full titanium. We have an absolutely gorgeous backspace with integrated lanyard loop. And also here at the back, we have the extended backspacer where you can see that they inched out every last millimeter of that blade that they could put into this overall handle design. This is the redesigned Neon. I never liked the original Neon with the standard drop point kind of blade shape. This blade is so much more attractive. You have this light upswept. You have the gorgeous long swedge here that also has this very nicely executed jimping on it. Super, super thin edge. Great EDC piece. This is still one of my absolute favorite EDC knives. It has a little bit of a strong pocket clip tension there. Also got some scratches, but the pocket clip would be the only thing that could be improved. Otherwise, action, overall design, internal milling. This is a real higher end production, Shurigorov, and really, really like it. Love the size and amazed by how much blade they could pack into this EDC-able nice little size that they have here on the Neon Zero. So very, very nice knife. And probably if I only could keep one Shiro, it would probably be this one, just because it has a more EDC-able size than the Neon and F95 NL. I also had a Neon NL, but in the end I decided that I wanted this higher end NL, this higher end Neon version, because the Neon NL is so lightweight. It doesn't have the backspacer. It has a more standard kind of blade shape, and in the end I decided I wanted to keep this one here also because this has a little bit of stronger detent and the better more defined action in my personal opinion. Then here we have one of my Chris Reeve knives. This is the Umnumzahn, which is in my opinion design wise the most gorgeous knife that Chris Reeve has ever done. Love the blade shape here with that nice swatch at the front. This is a newer version with the over travel stop and the new style pivot. Also not a knife that I carry a lot. This is more of a keepsake in the collection to have a Umnumzahn, a small Sebenza, and a Nandi. So I have all the knives I really want from Chris Reeve knives in the collection there. Super, super ergonomic. Carry this around in the house, for example, but I'm not really using or abusing this knife. This is more of a gorgeous design that I just like to have. And you can see it's pretty much in great condition because of that. Absolutely gorgeous piece. Nothing more I can say about this, just something you really should experience if you like some larger knives or just are a big fan of Chris Reeve knives. We jump over this into the other Chris Reeves just now so you can get a full overview. So here we have the small Sebenza 21 in Singo with micarta inlays. This is one of the knives that is most nearest and dearest to my heart because this is one of the first presents I got from my girlfriend. Super, super generous gift and just an absolutely gorgeous EDC piece. This was carried and used, you can see that on the poco clip, and still is carried and used sometimes, but I just don't want to lose it, so I'm very careful when and where I carry this knife. But it's so, so well done, very nice and thinly ground, hollow grind, perfect tip to open packages and leathers. Very, very smooth overall, typical Sebenza style action, free falling and so, so smooth and defined. So very, very happy with the small Sebenza 21 in Singo. Is a four finger knife for me with my small to medium hands there. And then we have the Chris Reeve Nandi, which was the last one that was added to the collection. This has some spalted beechwood handles. Other than that, standard Nandi fare. Have the gorgeous drop point blade shape, rounded spine, some fine jimping. We have the frame lock right here. It's easy to disengage. I just wish that they would chamfer this edge right here because this can be a little bit sharp, especially at this price point. Action is extremely smooth. It's hard to open with one hand. You have to kind of pinch and pull it out with two fingers there, and then you can open it with one hand, because this is also the newer version where they knock down a little bit of this area right here, so it's not as easy to open it with one hand. And without the pinch thing I do, it's pretty much impossible to open it one-handed for me. So absolutely gorgeous piece here, the Chris Reeve Nundy. Also, you have the logo, the blue anodizing on the pivot screw there. So now that you have the Chris Reeve through, let's go back to this one here. This is probably a knife that not a lot of you guys have already seen. This is a full custom knife by a Belgian part-time knife maker called Simon Strikkers. It's one of his newer models, I believe. This is the Tour model, which is one of his flipper models. We have a steel that's very similar to N690, full titanium construction, tapered handle shape there. Here is his logo. Very well done. And the action on this thing is absolutely amazing. So well dialed in, nice and free falling. Runs on a ball bearing pivot, of course. We have a gorgeous hand wrap set in drop point style blade. Insanely thinly ground there. Perfect lockup without any stainless steel insert. No lock stick whatsoever. Nice overall action. And this is just an absolute laser beam in use. And a super, super gorgeous knife. So I'm very happy that I actually won the option to buy this in the lotto that he did on Instagram. Follow him on Instagram to check out all his knives. And his knives are insanely affordable. So this knife, fully handmade titanium frame lock flipper on bearings with an N690 blade and a perfect action, as well as a 3D milled pocket clip there, runs 375 euros. That's what I paid for this one here. And this will stay in the collection for a long time. Just can't put it down and have carried this so many times here since I already got it. So very, very nice knife. Simon Strikkers, check him out on Instagram. I will link all the custom makers in the description below so they are a little bit easier to find. This one here is also a custom that I got new in this year. And here a aftermarket trade has gone wrong because the guy that sold it to me actually messed with it and kind of broke it and then shipped it off to me without mentioning anything. But I got it fixed by the maker, very cool maker, very fun to interact with him, very responsive, and took care of it, no problem, just had to pay shipping, of course. But a very, very nice experience here with Casey Gray. This is his Squeegee model, which is, I believe this is a small Squeegee. You have a very interesting blade shape, mirror polished edge. We have a nice dark stone wash finish on here. Then we have a zirconium thumb disc right there. We have zirconium pivot collars. We have black coated liners and screws. We have a zirconium pocket clip and a zirconium floating backspacer. So very, very high end. We also have Westinghouse micarta here, white micarta with that gorgeous older tan, looks a little bit like bone, for example. And very nice and smooth runs on phosphor bronze washers, which were actually missing when I got it first from the guy I bought it from. So that was a real surprise, had massive play, of course. Now it's super solid in every direction, fixed up perfectly by the maker. So thanks again for that, Casey Gray. And the steel is M390, so very nice high-end piece. And the prices on these knives from Casey Gray are actually also quite reasonable. I believe this one ran around 600 or something new from the maker. I paid a little bit less, but you know, all the hassle I had to go through for after I got this knife, it wasn't really worth it. But in the end, I'm very happy with it. Nice and hand filling, a great spot for your thumb right there, and just an absolutely gorgeous looking knife in my opinion, with the combination of materials that he has done here. Also a great anodized custom pivot screw, just a great little EDC piece, and so well in the hand. Pocket clip functions flawlessly. Great little piece here, the Squeegee by Casey Gray Knives. Then move down here, you know, probably have seen a couple of times these knives right here. These are my two Urban Trapper Arcs from Brad Zinker. The story behind why I got two of these knives is in the video about these knives, so check that one out. Both are amazing, love them both. One is Elmax, one is CPM 154. Both have sandbar stag handles. Of course, it's a natural material, so they look a little bit different. Both have perfect deep carry pocket clips, and I'm in love with both of them. Very, very gorgeous front flippers, runs on bearings, perfect lockup, just a work of an absolute master of his craft, and I love both. This is more of the safe cream because I love the texturing of the sandbar stag very much here, and this is also the 154 cm blade steel, and the polishing is done slightly nicer on this one. And this is the one that I actually carry and use because it has the Elmax steel and the a little bit less textured sandbar stag, so that's why I chose to make this one the carrying and user, and this one is more of the stay at home in the case and taking out for some presentation Urban Trapper Arc. But at first I wasn't intending to getting two, so that's just what I made them after the fact. So gorgeous knives, super ergonomic, very nice hollow grind, very nice finishing overall, really feels like a piece of jewelry. Very, very happy with the Urban Trapper Arcs here from Brad Zinker, also one of my absolute favorite custom knife makers. Then here we have a knife from Guy Poggetti out of France. This is his Sanyo model, which is this more Quaken style design blade. We also have an Elmax blade here. We have gorgeous Tasmanian blackwood scales. We have a liner lock, nice 3D milled pocket clip, which you see not that often on his Sanyo models. Normally he doesn't have a clip on this model. Looks very narrow, but actually works great on my pants. Here we have a carbon fiber backspacer, and of course an amazing ball bearing action here on this knife. We have a great detent, and you can hear it really sounds like you're racking a shotgun or something like that. Very, very authoritative deployment, very smooth, and works great and just looks absolutely gorgeous. One of my favorite overall custom designs, just very well executed here by Guy Poggetti out of France. And these are actually quite hard to get from, especially directly from the makers. And I'm very thankful to Guy that he actually made this one to my specifications. And then moving on from here, we have the Skiff Bladeworks Drifter, which is one of the newer acquisitions. This is a full custom drifter, which I got from the secondary market after I saw a video by Eugene Korn, which is a great knife reviewer. Check out his channel out as well. He has some great knives, some great customs, also some production knives, and does some very well-founded, well-articulated, longer kind of reviews. And he showed this knife off. Before that, I never heard of Skiff knives, but I was absolutely enamored by the quality that they deliver. All the little touches, all the polishing work, the satin finishing work, the overall design, the gorgeous milling, and everything that they put into their knives. And I needed to have one, and I found this Drifter number 6. So only the 6th Drifter that was ever made is this one here. And then I pulled the trigger and got it. Absolutely gorgeous piece, and I'm actually also on their books for my personal drifter, where I will go a little bit of different route. I'm going to go for zirconium on the accents everywhere, as well as the clip, and then I will opt for a zirconium backspacer as well instead of the standoffs here. But other than that, super, super gorgeous piece, very, very functional, nice and thinly ground, and just an absolute jewel of a CNC machined custom folder. Action is absolutely amazing. As you have seen here, a little bit of a large flipper tab, but other than that, super, super well done. The Skiff Knives Drifter, which is their newest model that they offer at the moment. Then some older custom knives that are in my collection are these two here. These are Chebukov knives. This is a Chebukov knives toucan with micarta inlays, M390 steel, super great action on a ball bearing pivot, nice and chunky EDC piece, some good jimping at the top there, We have this gorgeous titanium angled thumb stud, everything anodized in this nice bronze. We have the proprietary screws all around. Deep carry poker clip without an inlay underneath. They're very well thought through. That is something that I asked specifically for. We have a half length titanium backspacer, stainless steel lock bar insert. This was actually made in the year 2017, so it's in my collection for quite a long time. And then we have this very fine kind of Shirogorov like finish on the blade, which is reflective, perfectly centered, and just a gorgeous piece and one of the most unique designs that the Chebrikov knife is actually offering at the moment. So very, very nice here, the Toucan from Chebrikov Knives. And the other knife I got from the Chebrikovs is this one here. This is a small Strich in a pretty dressed up version. Here we have a laminated D2 steel, everything anodized bronze on the handle, as well as the pivot, the thumb stud, the pivot of course as well. Then we have some blue colored camel bone inserts on one side. Here the newer clip with some jimping, so it's easier to get it in and out of your pocket. We have only a one-sided thumb stud there, which is not removable. You can see it's like pinned in there. And then we have a liner lock that is also anodized or heat colored bronze with a great finish, super easy to disengage, very, very smooth overall. This can also be used as a front flipper, I found out later. Not designed as that, but it actually works very well as a front flipper, this small Strich here. Super ergonomic, nice jimping here at the top. Love that sandwich laminated construction that you can see from every angle. Nice and sharp, great full flat grind, nice functional tip. And we have a smaller backspacer here as well. Great piece here, and also the inlays are screwed in from the inside, not just glued. So absolutely gorgeous piece here, the Chebrikov small Strich in laminated D2 and camel bone inlays on a bronze anodized titanium frame with a liner lock. And then the last two I have to show you is this one here, which is my top knife of 2020. This is the OZ Machine Company Roosevelt, the first one with a stabby grind. This is a model number or serial number 43. And it features some crosscut or blackwood carbon fiber, zirconium pivot and backspacer, as well as clip, a blasted, dark blasted titanium lock side, and a Z-finite blade. On the inside, no milling, nothing special there, except my initials, which are engraved here at the top. So absolutely perfect EDC piece, super lightweight, love the stabby grind, very easy to puncture and to open packages and letters, super sharp, nice and high flat grind that comes down to a super nice and thin cutting edge. Very, very ergonomic in this grip, full four finger grip. You can also grip backward here where I can squeeze my last finger on it, but it's an absolute home run knife. As I said once before, this one here, the Roosevelt, and this Gift Drifter are probably the best modern knife makers that are at work at the moment in terms of new makers. Absolutely gorgeous pieces, both of them. And if you like thumbhole deployments, go with this. If you're more of a flipper guy, check out the Skiffs to get on their list. On the OZ Machine Company, ordering list at the moment, or the books are actually closed, but I think you will reopen it at the beginning of next year. So stay tuned and get yourself a Roosevelt. You will not be disappointed. This is one of my absolute favorite custom knives, especially for a new maker to come out of the gate with something as impressive as this. Is very, very nicely done, and I wasn't expected. And these Roosevelts have a pretty large bandwidth of where it can go price-wise. This, of course, is a little bit a more expensive one. This goes around 1,000, considered everything. And it's very, very fun to work with the guy at OZ Bladeworks. I believe it's a one-man shop. Unfortunately, I just forgot his name. I have a card right here. Maybe I can... It's probably Dan, I would say. I go with Dan. Sorry if I forgot your first name there, but here you can see all the information. I got it since May. And it's so fun to work with him. He's very open to work with you on some design tweaks on his design. As I said before, I recommended doing a slightly more stabbier grind. Another guy introduced a swatch into this model, and he's very open to suggestions and really fun to talk to, very responsive and just a great maker to support. And he is working away, manages everything very well with the orders. Never heard any complaints. We have not been responsive, losing orders or anything like that. So certainly an absolute good to go maker here to getting your Roosevelt from, and highly recommended by me. So stay tuned to get on his books once they reopen on the beginning of 2021. Absolutely gorgeous piece and my favorite knife of this year. And now we have just one knife to go, and that is this one here. Sticking around in the collection, my only knife from Rockstead at the moment. I sold the other Tanto version that I have, the Chi. Now I only have the Ku here, which is my favorite because we have the full grind here, the full convex grind on the YXR7 steel with the DLC coating. Also, the Ku is no longer being made, and this is the best version. It's like a small Shi, super, super ergonomic for me, with the Ergal aluminum handle scales. We have the gorgeous inlay of ray skin there. We have the mirror polish DLC finish. This is serial number 199, deep carry, very well executed clip that works really well. I carried this in the beginning. Now I'm not going to carry it that much because it's discontinued. But sometimes if I'm going to some special occasion, maybe even on Christmas, I could consider carrying the Ku here. Just a gorgeous piece, and I'm very happy that I could get just the right Rockstead in the collection for me. Great size, have all the things that the Rockstead represents for me, with the DLC, with the full convex grind and everything, and the deep carry clip, because there's also a version with another clip of the Ku available, an older one, but I really wanted this one, and I'm very happy that I have this in my collection, and this will also stay for a very, very long time. So this was the whole collection overview. Probably this will run over an hour. I hope you were interested in it. If you have any questions, put them down below. I will try to link everything we talked about here. If you're interested in any particular video on these knives, please search them on my channel. There are over 300 or 400 videos there on all these knives for you to check out. If you want to buy anything or are interested in anything I showed here, shoot me a message. The baddest thing I could say is no. I hope this was interesting to you. If you want, please follow me on Instagram at @7ready_knives_reviews. If you want to get some new knives, check out whitemountainknives.com and use my discount code 7ready to get 10% off your entire order. And if you want to support the channel and get early access to all of my videos, please check out my Patreon page, and you will find a link to everything in the description below. So thank you for watching. Let me know what your favorite purchase of this year was. That would be very interesting to me. And have a nice day, and goodbye.